One, two, three.
Try to get a little bit warmed up with some tunes that I haven't done in a while, and hopefully they'll go well. Sometimes things are a little blocked. I've sort of felt blocked lately, and I still do, but I'm not going to complain about being blocked. I'm just going to try to look at it as an opportunity. This is a new concept I've been thinking about lately. Blocked, you know, physically or even mentally. Actually, I feel like I've got a bit of a fog in my head. It could just be from sinus infection, which I seem to have. But physically blocked too, where I feel like there's a bit of a slight wall between me and my music, which you know, there always is a little bit of a little nebulosity between what you're trying to do and what's coming out. And that's the point of practice, to try to improve the connection to the point of perfection. And of course, perfection is unattainable, so you just want to get as close as you can. And so I'm feeling a little further away. And when I go back and listen to some of these recordings, I realize that I'm not really hearing it objectively. And that's probably true for everyone. You're not really objective about your own playing because of strange personal feelings about what's going on in the moment. So rather than complaining about feeling blocked or complaining internally, I'm going to be examining a new concept around it, which is that it's a window to new forms of expression. So say you're used to playing a certain language of music that's kind of your own, or maybe you're not as advanced, and so you don't have as much of your own language, and you're just borrowing other people's, which is, that's what we all do. Jazz musicians all do that. We steal from each other, and it's a time-honored tradition, so there's nothing wrong with copying others. And then as you gain experience, you start to develop your own language. But sometimes, and I think this happens for many of us, we start kind of playing the same stuff a lot. And we have our own language, and we seem to be repeating a lot of the same words of it. And I'm going to look at the idea of feeling blocked or feeling like things aren't flowing from the perspective that it's an opportunity to find new bits and pieces of personal artistic language. And they may not feel very comfortable at first because they're new. And you have to avoid judging them too, because if it's new, then you haven't been practicing it. Obviously, it's not going to feel very comfortable. But if you avoid this, and you say, well, I only want to play what's comfortable, then you might miss out on the opportunity to have something new come out of your instrument. Now, I'm not saying that anything will today. It's just my attitude. My attitude is to be open to feeling blocked and feeling like I'm not really there as an opportunity, and not a bad thing. Here's Black Orpheus.
One, two, one, two, three. Thank you.
I think I'm going to play that again, and we'll see about some double time on this one. Black Orpheus, take two.
One, two, three. Thank you.
Okay, that was take two. Black Orpheus, what we Americans call Black Orpheus, but the actual title is Mañana Carnival, by Luis Bonfa. Luis Bonfa. Next up, I'm going to change it up a little bit. Let me just check something here. This is called Blue Train. Blue Train.
One, two, a one, two.
Thank you.
that was Blue Train by John Coltrane. The spelling, of course, is different. We often say T-R-A-N-E because it's the last five letters of his name, but this one is called T-R-A-I-N, Blue Train. It's from the same album, which I think is his only Blue Note album, Blue Train. I'm going to change things up yet again and play a song that I associate with Sonny Rollins, but this version of it is nothing like his version. In fact, this version of it is like nothing I've heard of this song. But it does remind me of the way some other songs are played, with a Latin head that switches to swing up tempo. So here is an oddball version of a tune called Dearly Beloved. Dearly Beloved.
One, two, one, two, three, four. One, two, one, two, three, four.
Thank you.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Dearly beloved, in an odd sort of pseudo samba swing, dearly beloved. Mercer, Johnny Mercer, Jerome Kern. I'm a little late on this one. This is autumn in New York. It's already just about winter in New York, so we're a little late, but that's okay. Autumn in New York.
One, two, three, four.
Check. I don't always know if I turn the mic off. Autumn in New York. I have another autumn tune. This is Autumn Leaves in the wrong key. I think the better key is G minor, but this one's in E minor.
One, two, one.
One, two, three. Thank you.
got you under my skin. Again, a little strange Latin version of that. I've got you under my skin. All right, I'm gonna take a chance on this next one here. So this is a little faster. It's called From This Moment On. It's hard to get the information on these songs nowadays on the internet because there's not a whole lot of respect for the original composers, and so you end up with a list of songs named From This Moment On, albums named From This Moment On. And often, they will not be the accurate one. There will be some new pop song that uses exactly the same title, or there might be an album that has the original, but it will simply tell you the artist who recorded the album and not the composer that wrote the piece. However, if you have a little bit of patience, you can dig and find out that it's Cole Porter, which I should have known anyway, but like I said, my mind's a little foggy from having this sinus issue. So here is From This Moment On, Up.
One, two, one, two, three, four. Thank you. One, two, one, two, three, four.
Okay, that was two versions on From This Moment On, Cole Porter. And my chops are starting to get kind of tired, so I think one more pretty song for you, and then I will call it a day. Which song to play? Okay, here is Jimmy Van Heusen, Darn That Dream. Once again, thank you very much for joining me on this Friday afternoon in the Eastern time zone. I'll be back soon, and I look forward to seeing you again. You have my gratitude for joining me, and I hope you've enjoyed this, and my background today is Vermeer, Johannes Vermeer. This is called The Art of Painting, although I don't think he titled any of his works. This is just what they call it. And final song for you, Darn That Dream.
One, two, three, four. Mm-hmm.